There's a brand new update that just came out to WordPress that's going to have a new welcome screen that's going to encourage people to install and try Gutenberg. We're going to go over that in this video. We're going to go over what happens when you actually install Gutenberg and how it interacts with your page builder and all of that. This is a very good video to know what's going on if you have a website yourself or you have clients that log into their websites. We're going to touch on that in this video. Hi, my name is Adam from WPCrafter.com. where I make tactics and tutorial videos for non-techies to help you grow your influence and income online. If you're new here, consider clicking on the subscribe button. If you want notifications, click on the notification bell. All right, let's jump in. This is what's going to happen. You log into your WordPress website. Well, you know, my WordPress sites, they just automatically update when it's not a major update. So that might happen to you, but this is what your clients might see or you might see when you log in. It'll say WordPress 4.9.8 is now available. Now, after you go ahead and update, you're going to see this, and essentially it's going to do some minor things. It's going to fix 46 bugs, but that is not why I'm making this video. This is why I'm making this video, because after you get this new update and you go onto the dashboard, you see this new screen right here, and essentially it is promoting Gutenberg, which is the new editor for editing content that's coming to WordPress on all WordPress websites when WordPress version 5 gets released very soon. Now there's a dismiss button right here in the top right corner that you can click on, and that will make that go away. If you don't click on that, it's not going anywhere. So what I thought I'd do is just go ahead and install Gutenberg. So I went ahead and clicked on the install Gutenberg button. After it installs and you click on activate, it immediately takes you right here, and you're like, what the heck is it taking me to? Essentially, this is just a new post where you could save it if you want and start getting comfortable with Gutenberg. So let me show you what happens. I'll just go ahead and get out of this. So if you go ahead and you look at all the pages of content, this is a website. You can see these pages here have all been built with Elementor. So this is what happens now. You see the difference is with the button here. Now, if you're using other page builders like Divi or Beaver Builder, the behavior is going to be exactly the same. They've all kind of done the same thing. Okay, so right now, before you just click Add New to create a new page, now you actually have this little drop down, and this is how it's going to be after you install WordPress version 5 when it's released later this year. So I'll go to the drop down, and I have this option to create a new page with Elementor, with Gutenberg, or with the classic editor. Now, I believe when version 5 of WordPress is released, this classic editor is not going to be an option any longer. So this is what a existing page will end up looking like. So I have this page right here, case studies. It's made with Elementor. Now, when I click in it, it just looks a little different. Now, let me just say, I don't recommend anyone do this. I do recommend, though, if you have a website and are managing websites, to set up a staging area so you can test this out on your website, because all of us are going to have to get comfortable using the Gutenberg editor. We're just going to have to do it, and it's going to feel uncomfortable at first. However, you'll eventually get the hang of it. Now, this is what it looks like. So right now, it's just showing me the page title, which is right here. And then I have my large edit with Elementor button right here. Now, if I wanted to stop using Elementor on this page, I can click this button here that says back to WordPress editor. Now, normally when you would click into a page, right, you would see your content area, and then underneath it, you might have these things called meta boxes, or I like to use normal English and just call them option boxes. Now, the theme I have on this site is the Astra theme. It doesn't do that. It doesn't have this big multi-tab option box thing that you might see with other themes, but it would have these options in the right column. And so you could see it gets merged over here. So it says right here, Astra settings, and then right here is those normal Astra settings. So it kind of feels native. I do need to test this with other themes like Ocean WP, and I think GeneratePress also has these big option boxes with multiple tabs on it to see how it kind of shrinks into this framework, because these option boxes are no longer going to be underneath the content area when you're using Gutenberg on a particular page. Now, I know those developers are probably totally on top of everything, and they've got their plan set of how to like scrunch it into the corner right here or what they're going to do. But this is going to feel uncomfortable at first and for a while. So this is kind of all normal, and you have your other options here. They collapse now. So if I wanted to do a featured image, I can go right here and do it. Discussion would be to allow comments, my page attributes right here, and all of that. Now, what's really interesting about this, as soon as WordPress 5 is released, every single WordPress tutorial video that you see on YouTube, they're all gonna not match up with what people are using, because this is now going to be the interface. And Gutenberg itself is, you know, it's block based. So if you're using a modern page builder, you're used to sections and columns, or if you're using Beaver Builder, they use the terminology rows. So it's gonna be a lot like that. So if I go to create a new Gutenberg page right here, it's all visual. So I would go here, pop my title in, and then I have a series of blocks right here, and I can click on a plus and I can put in different types of blocks that are here. I know a lot of developers are going to probably be coming out with block packs that you can easily add and rearrange. It's going to be an interesting transition for sure. I personally think it's about time that WordPress has a new interface. There's a lot of stuff in here that can overwhelm somebody right away, and I personally look forward to this Gutenberg change. However, I just wanted to let you know in this video that if you go ahead and see that option to put Gutenberg in, it's going to download the Gutenberg plugin, install it. You could test it out on your site. It's not going to break anything, but for sure you don't want to go ahead and do that on your live sites. Definitely try it on a staging site. And right now really is the time to start getting comfortable with Gutenberg. I think I'll probably put together an introduction to Gutenberg video so that people can start to feel more comfortable, because it actually feels very uncomfortable at first, especially if you're like me. I'm in my early 40s. Anything different makes me feel uncomfortable right away, but I'm sure I'll get used to it right away. So anyways, that's all I have for you in this video. Just a quick little warning video letting you know what is out there, especially if you have clients, because they might be asking you about this Gutenberg thing. Hey, if you found any value in this video, go ahead and give it a thumbs up. Ask any comments in the comment section down below. Other than that, I'll see you in the next video.